Hey guys, welcome back to Royalty Now. I'm Becca and I'm here with another subject for you. Today's subject is an archer from the Terracotta Army. So I thought it would be fun to bring to life an individual member of the Terracotta Army. If you haven't heard of this, the full army was constructed as an afterlife guard to accompany the tomb of China's first emperor around 210 BCE. Now, this massive archaeological site, the size of an airplane hangar, was found on accident by men digging a well. Each figure is basically a representation of a soldier meant to guard the emperor in the afterlife. So they are not based upon real soldiers, but they do actually all differ in facial expressions, clothing, and everything. So actually each soldier in the Terracotta Army looks unique. So while I'm not actually making or representing a real person here that lived in 210 BC, I just thought it would be fun to bring to life one of these unique soldiers. Scholars have identified about 10 basic face molds used in the creation of these figures that were once painted. Clay would then be added after assembly to provide individualized features to make each figure appear different. There are about 8,000 terracotta soldiers in this army. I just think it's such a testament to the unique artistry of the time and just the scale and mastery that went into creating this for the emperor. Now, I'm sure it's obvious that I cut out a lot of these videos. I really just want to show you guys the highlights of creating these soldiers in Photoshop and not bog you down with a 3-hour video of the creation process. Each figure does take about 3 to 4 hours. My main artistic process with this one was actually inserting the image of the terracotta soldier into ArtBreeder. From there, I got an approximation that I began working from, and then I molded and recolored and retextured that one to fit the image of the terracotta archer. I don't do this for every one of my creations, but this was the process for this one here. I hope you enjoy.